गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन् उतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ भद्रं कर्णेभिः शृणुयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागंसस्तनूभिः व्यशेम देवहितं यदायुः। स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी आर इन दिस मुंडकोपनिषद द फर्स्ट अध्याय सेकंड पार्ट दट इज सेकंड खंड फर्स्ट मुंडकम सेकंड खंड सेवेंथ श्लोक वी कंप्लीटेड सेवेंथ मंत्र वी कंप्लीटेड इन द लास्ट क्लास दट इज प्लवाह्यते ह्यदृढ़ा प्लवाह्यते अदृढ़ा यज्ञरूपाः अष्टादशोक्तम अवरम येषु कर्म सो दट मंत्र वी कंप्लीटेड अलांग विद द भाष्यम सो वी हैव बीन सीइंग दट द उपनिषद इज नाउ say trying to present before us what is this aparavidya. Aparavidya, as we know, is the lower level of knowledge in contrast to that paravidya, the higher level of higher knowledge. Higher knowledge is about the self, the lower knowledge is about the world. So that is the thing which we are seeing now. And say the Upanishad itself is saying, though all these entire aparavidya also is a part and parcel of the Veda. Aparavidya, this yajna, all these things, various yajnas, or it may be something else like upasana, all these things, they are part and parcel of the, say, Vedas. But still, Vedas, they say, though it is there contained in the Veda, it is something like a 10th class level, but you have to graduate to a higher level, some postgraduate level, or say, doctoral level. So if we have to do that, then we have to drop off this avidya. We have to drop off this avidya, get the benefit out of avidya. Get the benefit out of avidya means this avidya also properly performed, it leads to chitta shuddhi. It leads to purification of mind. And also it leads to upasana and things like that. It also leads to purification of vasanas. Not only purification of karma, but also eradication of some bad vasanas, etc. That is the basic effect of upasana. So with all these, then you have to go to the level of Atma Shodhana, that is, who am I? That inquiry into the nature of the self. So that we are going to see. But now we are still, some more verses are there, some more mantras are there, which are telling us about the avidya. The basic point we have to note is that the Upanishad, while being, say, part of a religious text, it is asking us to go beyond the religion, beyond the organized religion as we see now. Organized religion is a belief system. A belief system, okay, this God is like this, heaven is like this, hell is like this, these are the lokas. So now we have seen that all these lokas are your own creation, all the lokas are your own experiential states, and then you have to go beyond that, and then you have to see what is your real nature. So next mantra, let us read. अविद्यायामंतरे वर्तमानाः स्वयं धीरा पंडितं मन्यमानाः जंघन्यमानाः परियन्ति मूढा अंधेनैव नीयमाना यथांधाः। ओके, अविद्यायाम अंतरे वर्तमान। सो दिस मंत्र इज टेलिंग अस अबाउट द पीपल हु आर जस्ट वांडरिंग एंड वांडरिंग इन दिस रेलम ऑफ अविद्या फ्लाउंडरिंग इन दिस रेलम ऑफ अविद्या सो इट सेज दीज आर द पीपल हु आर जस्ट से वांडरिंग इन द रेलम ऑफ दिस अविद्या बट देन दे डोंट नो दैट दे आर इन द रेलम ऑफ अविद्या बट एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड दे थिंक दैट दे आर द ग्रेट स्कॉलर्स दे आर द ग्रेट से नॉलेजेबल पीपल. And then, because of such false knowledge, janghanyamanaha, they get beaten repeatedly. Hanyamanaha, punah punah hanyamanaha is janghanyamanaha. That is, they get beaten repeatedly, and then just as and then fall. They get beaten repeatedly and also fall, just as the people who are, just as the blind people led by the blind. So that is the mantra. Avidyayam antare. Antare means in the realm of avidya. Avidya means ignorance. Avidya does not mean absence of knowledge. Avidya, you see, this na plus vidya is avidya. Isn't it? Na plus vidya is avidya. Anything which is, if you put that na, it means absence of a thing. Isn't it? Abhayam, absence of bhayam, is abhaya. Here, it is a slightly different thing. Avidya, upasarga nai, it is used in different senses. That is, to negate a thing, or to tell about the absence of a thing, or to tell that it is something which is totally, say, topsy-turvy. That is, na plus vidya, it does not mean the absence of vidya, but then the presence of something else which is other than real vidya. So that is it. So there are two technical terms called prasajya pratishedha and paryudasa. We need not go into the grammar. Prasajya pratishedha means when whatever is the subject matter there, vidya is the subject matter there. Tasya pratishedha, prasajya pratishedha, prasaktasya pratishedha. That is to negate or to say that it is totally absent. So it is not about the absence of a thing, but to tell about pariyudasa, something which is perverted. You can say perverted or topsy-turvy, wrong understanding, something which is understood in a totally different way. So that is the meaning of pariyudasa. So here it is used in that pariyudasa sense and not in that prasajya pratishedha sense. So avidya does not mean lack of anything, total, ignorant fellow, but he is knowing the wrong type of knowledge. So what he thinks is knowledge is not knowledge. So that is the point. Avidyayam antare vartamanaha. Vartamanaha means those who are moving in that thing. Vartamanaha. Vartate. You know that vartate. Vartamanaha. Shanach pratyaya. Then swayam dhiraha. For themselves, swayam dhiraha panditam manyamanaha. Swayam manyamanaha. On their own, manyamanaha. They visualize, they fancy, let us say fancy, that they are the dhiraha. Dhiraha, panditaha, panditam manyamanaha. So they think that they are the dhiras, they are the dhira. Then dhira means they are the wise people. Dhira in the context of Vedanta, dhira does not mean a valiant person who will fight. But then dhira means somebody dhiyam buddhivruttim rati grunhati is dhira. That is one who has absolute control of his mind. So that is what is a dhira. Then janghanyamanaha. Han dhatu. Hanti hataha ghananti. Han dhatu gets that form ghana. So janghanyamanaha, that is muhurmuhu hanyamanaha, again and again, bhrusham hanyamanaha, that is again and again getting hit, getting kicked. So that is it, getting kicked. Pariyanti, pariyanti means they just move about. They just move about. How is it? That is, for example, you visualize, just to have take some concrete example, you visualize some person, he goes to some temple today, he has some desire and he goes to one temple today. So he suddenly thinks that somebody else comes and says, no, this temple is, this Lord is not very powerful. You go to some other temple. So he will go to some other temple. And somebody else will come and say, no, you go to Shirdi Sai Baba temple. So he will go to Shirdi Sai Baba, though he has nothing to do with our Hinduism. Then again, what else? He will do some yajna. So somebody will say, no, not this yajna. You have to do another type of Lalita Parayanam. So then he does Lalita Parayanam. Then after some time he moves over, he switches on to Vishnu Sahasranama. So something like this. So Pariyanti. Pariyanti means Paritaha Brahmanti. Here and there they keep on moving here and there. So with all their desires. So Pariyanti. Avidyayamantare vartamanaha janghanyamanaha. Pariyanti. Mudhaha. Mudhaha means Moham Gataha. Muhu. That is Moham. Moham is delusion. Mudhaha are deluded people. And then they move about. Like what? Andhena niyamanaha. Yatha andhaha andhena niyamanaha. Just as the blind people who are being led by the blind. So what will happen to them? They will all fall into some ditch. So that is what is going to say. Kincha bhashyam. Let us see. किंच अविद्यायाम अंतरे मध्ये वर्तमानाः अविवेकप्रायाः स्वयं वयमेव धीराः धीमन्तः पंडिताः विदित वेदितव्याश्च इति विदितवेदितव्याश्च इति मन्यमानाः आत्मानं संभावयन्तः
तेच
जंघन्यमानाः जरा रोगाद्यनेक अनर्थव्रातैर्हन्यमानाः भृशं पीड्यमानाः पर्यन्ति विभ्रमन्ति मूढाः ओके किंच दैट इज मोरओवर किंच मीन्स मोरओवर अविद्यायाम अंतरे अंतरे मीन्स मध्ये दैट इज इन द रेलम ऑफ अविद्या वर्तमानाः दैट इज दोस हु आर से डूइंग ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ एक्टिविटीज ऑल पर्स्यूइंग ऑल एक्टिविटीज इन द रेलम ऑफ अविद्या पर्स्यूइंग ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ एक्टिविटीज इन द रेलम ऑफ इग्नोरेंस सो सच पीपल अविवेक प्रायः एज गुड एज फूल्स अविवेक प्राय शब्द इज एज गुड एज अविवेक प्रायः अविवेकिनः मीन्स परफेक्टली फूल्स अविवेक सपोज ही सेज अविवेकिनः दैट इज परफेक्ट फूल्स दोस हू डोंट हैव विवेक हियर दे आर अविवेक प्रायः ऑलमोस्ट फूल्स लाइक दैट अविवेक प्रायः देन स्वयं वयमेव धीराः स्वयं ऑन देयर ओन वयमेव धीराः वी आर द धीराः धीमन्तः धी ही मीन्स बुद्धि धियम राति गृह्णाति इज बुद्धि धीरः दैट इज वन हू हैज ग्रेट इंटेलेक्ट वी आर द ग्रेट इंटेलेक्चुअल्स देन पंडिताः पंडिता इज विदित वेदितव्याश्च विदितम विदितम मीन्स नोन वेदितव्यम मीन्स व्हाट हैज टू बी नोन वेदितव्यम सो पुस्तकम वेदितव्यम पठितव्यम समथिंग ईटेबल इज भोक्तव्यम सो तव्य प्रत्यय वेदितव्यम इज विदितम दैट मीन्स वट एवर हैज टू बी नोन इज नोन दैट इज इट वट ऑल हैज टू बी नोन आई नो सो दैट इज वट ऑल हैज टू बी नोन आई नो सो दैट इज वॉट दे फील विदित वेदितव्या वेदितव्यम इज समथिंग टू बी नोन विदितम मीन्स नोन सो वट एवर हैज टू बी नोन इज नोन सो दट इज वॉट विदितम नने वेदितम विदितम यही वेदितव्यम विदितम यही ते विदित वेदितव्या इज ए बहुरी समास दट इज दोस हू फील दोस हू थिंक दट दे नो एवरीथिंग विच हैज टू बी नोन सो वी सी वी फाइंड समटाइम्स फाइंड पीपल हू वी कम अक्रॉस पीपल हू से Whatever I do not know is not worth knowing. So I have seen one famous gentleman who used to say, he is no more, whatever I do not know is not worth knowing. So such great megalomaniac people will be there. So vidita veditavyascha iti manyamanaha, that is atmanam sambhavayantaha, atma sambhavayantaha, that is atma sambhavanam. Sambhavanam is samyak bhavanam. Elevating themselves. Bhavana is idea. Sambhavanam is having an elevated idea. Atmanam sambhavayantaha. That is honoring themselves, elevating themselves, glorifying themselves. All these things. Glorifying themselves. Then janghanyamanaha. That is getting beaten again and again. By what? Jara rogadi aneka anartha vrataihi. Vratam means samuha. Samuha means group, samuha is a group. Anartha vrata he means by so many, several. Anartha vrata means several. So what are these anartha? Anartha means all types of bad things. Anartha what shall we say? Some not obstacle, not defect, but anartha is something which is some negative happening. Whatever is negative happening is anartha. What are they? Jara, that is old age. Then roga, disease, adi, etc. Aneka, several, anarthavratahi, several such heaps of, bad things. They keep on suffering. Several unwanted or rather, bad things you can say. All these unnecessary things, they are hanyamanaha. Hanyamana is getting beaten. Hanyamana, hanadhatu. Hanyamana is Karmani, that is somebody getting beaten. Hanyamanaha. What is that? Bhrusham. Bhrusham means what we brusha means intensely. Brusha is something which is intensely. Brusham pidyamanaha, those who are being tortured, those who are being tormented very seriously. Brusham pidyamanaha, then pariyanti vibhramanti mudhaha, they keep on moving from pillar to post, as we say in English, we say from pillar to post. So they keep on moving from here, there, from one god to another, from one religion to another, they keep on moving. So like that. Then darshana varjitatvad andhenaiva achakshushkenaiva
niyamanaha pradarshyamana margaha
yatha loke andhaha akshirahitaha
gartha kantakadau patanti tadvat.
Okay. Darshana varjitatvat. Darshana means jnana, vision. Drushir prekshana, isn't it? That is seeing. That is darshana, means knowledge. In fact, that is why we say shat darshanas. We say six systems of Indian philosophy, we call them darshana. What is the meaning of darshana? Darshana means a vision. So darshana is the knowledge. The knowledge or vision. Darshana varjitatvat, because these are not something which cannot be called knowledge. This is something, a belief system. Religion, we have to distinguish between those two things. I always keep on saying, because this text, being a religious text, it is asking you to go beyond the organized religion. And religion is something which is defining a God in a particular way. Defining God in a particular way means you are defining depending on your own samskara, depending on your own prejudices, your own love, hatred, desire, dislikes, etc., etc. You have visualized a God who is going to punish your enemy. You have visualized a God who is going to favor your tribe. You have visualized a God who is going to kill all other people who don't believe in him. So all these things are part and parcel of the religion. So this is not knowledge. This is something which is a dogma. Knowledge is different from dogma. So here, these are this darshana varjitatva, that's why it says, darshanam is trying to know what is the real nature of a human being. Whether he is in India or in Alaska or somewhere in Timbuktu, whatever is the place, what is the nature of a human being, what is the type of intelligence he has, what is the type of sensory perception he has. So this is the analysis. This analysis is done in the same Vedanta. The same Vedanta does analysis. And that is at a higher level. So that is why it says, till a person comes to that level of maturity, it says, okay, you keep on doing, you keep on observing practice. So that is the reason why we have seen in Bhagavad Gita, that is the reason why the Lord Krishna also says, you worship the divine in any form. In any form you want, yam vapi, not mm vapi, yo, yam yam tanum bhaktaha shraddhaya architum ichyati. So that is what we have to always remember. Why do we have so many gods and so many belief systems? That is because we know that the absolute truth is one, and depending on your own ability, depending on your own understanding, depending on your own level of maturity, you are visualizing a God in a particular way. Okay, you do that. And by that, you are achieving some sort of sense of self-discipline. You are achieving happiness. You are also achieving whatever you want. Because that divine thing is going to answer you in whatever form you are going to worship. So that is the reason why they have admitted everything. So this is one thing which we have to see. So here, darshana means real, the absolute reality. At a transactional reality, you have allowed every path. At an absolute reality, there is only one. There cannot be too many truths. There is only one truth. So that is the point. Darshana varjitatvad. Andhenaiva achakshushkena. Chakshushkaha means somebody who is having eyes. He is called a chakshushkaha. Chakshushkena, that is somebody who is having eyes. That is a person with eyes. Chakshushkenaiva. Achakshushkena means somebody who does not have eyes. That is a blind person. So by a blind person, niyamanaha nayadhatu, to lead. Pradarshyamana margaha. That is somebody, people to whom this path is being shown. Marga or path is being shown by a blind man. A blind man is showing the marga to many other people. देन यथा लोके अंधाः अक्षिरहिताः जस्ट एज पीपल हू आर हू डोंट हैव आईज अक्षिरहिताः गर्त कंटकादौ पतन्ति. गर्त मीन्स Guntur is named after that Gartapuri. Gartha means Gunta. It used to be a low-lying place, it seems. So, Gartha means a pit. So, they fall into a pit or Kantakadavu. They get into some thorns. In olden days, there used to be all thorns all along the road, country tracks. In all country tracks, there used to be so many thorns. But of course, nowadays, there are no thorns. But in those days, there used to be thorns. Gartha kantakadav patanti. They just fall into that thing. Tadvat. Tadvat means like that. Then the next mantra also is almost like that. Avidyaya mantare. Let us read. Avidyayam bahudha vartamanaha.
Avidyayam bahudha vartamanaha.
Vayam krutartha itya vimanyanti balaha. यत् कर्मिणो न प्रवेदयन्ति रागात् तेनातुरः क्षीणलोकाश्च्यवन्ते. ओके, देन् आल्मोस्ट् सिमिलर् लैन् इन् डिफरेण्ट् वर्ड्स्. अविद्यायां बहुधा वर्तमानाः. बहुधा मीन्स् इन् सेवरल् वेस्. Avidyayam antare, last mantra said, avidya antare, in the realm of avidya. Here, bahudha, in so many ways, because avidya has so much of diversity. Because vidya, there is only one truth. The truth cannot be many. But avidya can be several, because each man can have his own concept of God. Each man can visualize God as he likes, depending on his own level of maturity, level on his own understanding. So like that, bahudha vartamanaha, worshipping so many types of, in so many types of ways. Then, vayam krutarthaha, iti abhimanyanti balaha. You know the word krutartha. Krutam artham yena krutasa krutarthaha. That is, artha. Artham is whatever is the goal. Krutam, whatever has to be achieved has been achieved. That is krutam. Krutartha is somebody who has achieved the goal. So we have achieved the goal. Yeah, I have read all this the whole procedure about yajna. I have performed yajna in a very meticulous way. I know what all has to be known. That vidita veditavyaha. His knowledge of veditavyam is so limited. So his knowledge of veditavyam is so limited that he thinks that he knows everything. This veditavyam is something which depends on our own, knowledge, our own maturity. Suppose I am sitting here in this room, I have absolutely no idea about so many types of new branches of knowledge which are coming. And then I think that I know everything. So that is again foolishness, isn't it? So that is it. Pidyamanaha. Then here also the same thing. Bahudha vartamanaha vayam krutarthaha. Yeah, I have known everything. I have learnt. I have not known everything. Iti. Abhimanyanti bala, abhimanyanti. Abhimanyanti means they have that abhimana, they have that pride. They take pride. Abhimanyanti, they take pride. Balaha, balaha means, literal meaning of balaha is children. But here it is not children. Normally bala actually means, balaha is balakaha, child, a small boy. Bala in Shastra what they say is, Grahana dharana patur balaha. There is a small definition for balaha. Balabodhini, you say. Suppose there is a book called Balabodhini. There is a huge shastra. For that huge shastra, there is what is called Balabodhini. There is a tika. Tika means some sort of commentary. It does not mean that it is going to teach small children. It means that it will tell this shastra to somebody who is unacquainted with this shastra. Somebody who is an expert. You are an expert in mathematics. You do not know some other field. So, I take that some other subject and write a Balabodhini Tika. So, it is meant for you. That is, somebody who knows something else. But then, this particular subject he does not know. He is called Balaha. Grahana dharana patur Balaha natu stanandhayaha. There is a definition somewhere. That is, somebody who is able to grasp. Grahana. Dharana. Dharana means retain. Grahana dharana patuhu, one who has the capacity to understand and retain. So he is called balaha. Natu stanandhayaha. Stanandhayaha means a milk suckling baby. Not a milk suckling baby. So balaha here also means somebody who has ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ नॉलेज बट नॉट दिस रियल नॉलेज सो दैट इज इट सो ग्रहण कृतार्थः इति अभिमन्यन्ति बालाः दे आर ऑल कॉल्ड बालाः सो somebody who is a great somayaji he is a bala in this context so somebody who has absolutely no knowledge of brahma vidya somebody who is not bothered about shravana marana nididhyasana he is a bala so from our point of view we can take pride then yat karmino na pravedayanti ragat yat means here yat in the sense used in the sense of yasmat because of this Yes, yasmad evam. Shankaracharya is going to say, yes, yath means yasmad evam. That is because it is like this. Karminaha. Karminaha means those who are in the path of karma are called karminaha. Karmi. Karminaha. Karmi is somebody who is in the path of karma. Who thinks that karma is supreme, karma is the only duty to be done, karma is the ultimate, that is the be all and end all. So a person who thinks that karma is the be all and end all, he is a karmi. Karminaha is plural. Karminaha na pravedayanti. They are not able to understand. Why? Ragat. Because of their attachment. Raga. Attachment to what? Attachment to karma phala. They want this karma phala. So you do something and then you are having that karma phala. And that is because of their own sense of inadequacy. Their own sense of incompleteness. So they want to achieve something so that they can become complete. Purna madha purnamidam. They do not know that they are purna. They think that they are incomplete. They still want, they have to achieve something. They are having a very limited notion of themselves. So that is why they want to get more and more and more forever and forever. So that is the reason why they na pravedayanti ragat. Ragat means because of the desire for phalam. Then tena by which? By that raga. Because of that raga, because of that attachment, karma phala attachment, aturaha, atura means always in tension, aturaha, aturaha is somebody who is always tensed up, somebody who is always unhappy, tensed up, always desiring something, always in a state of anxiety. So they are the aturaha, anxiety, that is the point. Then they, kshinalokaha, chyavante, kshinalokaha means There, whatever punyam they attain, they go and stay for some time in some heavenly place. And then after that, that punya comes declining. As the punyam declines, they come back. As the punyam declines slowly, they do come back. That is the point. Kshina lokaha, chyavante, kshina punyaha. Kshina lokaha means kshina punyaha. Shankaracharya is going to say, yeah, kshina karma phalaha. So that karma phalam becomes weak and weak. So once that karma phalam becomes weak and weak, they come back, they slip down. That shyavante also is a beautiful word. Shyavate. They slip down. They slide down, let us say. They slide down or slip down to the earth or some other loka. So let us read the bhashyam. Kincha. Avidyayam bahudha bahuprakaram vartamanaha. वयमेव कृतार्थाः कृतप्रयोजनाः इत्येवम् अभिमन्यन्ति अभिमानं कुर्वन्ति बालाः अज्ञानिनः
अभिमन्यन्ते अज्ञानिनः
ओके यस्माद् यद् यस्माद् एवम्
यत् यस्मात् एवम्
कर्मिणो न प्रवेदयन्ति तत्त्वं न जानन्ति रागात् कर्मफल रागाभिभव निमित्तम् तेन कारणेन आतुराः दुःखार्ताः सन्तः क्षीणलोकाः क्षीणकर्मफलाः स्वर्गलोकात् च्यवन्ते ओके किञ्च मोर् ओवर् अविद्यायाम् इन् दिस् अविद्या बहुधा बहुप्रकारम् ऐ टोल्ड् यू बहुप्रकारम् मीन्स् ही इस् नाट् साटिस्फैड् वित् वन् टैप् आफ़् रिचुवल् ही गोस् फ्रम् स्वामीजी टु स्वामी फ्रम् मौल्वी टु मौल्वी फ्रम् सो अण्ड् सो पर्सन् टु सम् अदर् पर्सन् फार् सो मेनी टालिस्मेन्स् अण्ड् सो मेनी थिङ्ग्स् बहुधा बहुप्रकारं वर्तमानाः देन् बट् देन् दे थिङ्क् वयम् ऐ नो दिस् यज्ञ ऐ नो दट् यज्ञ ऐ नो हण्ड्रेड् टैप्स् आफ़् यज्ञ वयमेव कृतार्थाः अर्थम् इस् प्रयोजन वट् एवर् इस् दट् गोल् आब्जेक्टिव् कृतप्रयोजनः वी नो एव्रिथिङ्ग् इत्येवं लैक् देट् Abhimanyanti, abhimanam kurvanti. They take pride. They take pride in their knowledge. They take pride in their learning. They take pride in their achievements. Yes, I have done this yajna. I am going to achieve this particular loka. Then balaha ajnaninaha. They are the ajnaninaha. They are the ignorant people. Balaha. Then yes, yat karmino. That second line. Yat karmino. Yat means yasmat evam. Because it is like this. Because their position is like this. They are so sadly situated. Then karminaha na pravedayanti. That is vidha dhatu means to see, to know. Vidha is to see, yeah. To know. Na pravedayanti means they tattvam na jananti. They cannot know the reality. They cannot know the reality of the thing. Why? Ragat karma phala raga abhibhava nimittam. They are all karma because of this karma phala raga, because of their desire for this karma phala abhibhava. Their knowledge is defeated. Their intelligence is defeated. Abhibhava. Abhibhavati means to defeat. Abhibhavati. That is, their knowledge is defeated, their wisdom is defeated by the desire for the karma phala. Otherwise, they would have been okay. But their desire has overtaken. Their desire has defeated their intelligence. Karma phala raga abhibhava nimittam. Because of the reason that their intelligence is driven away or defeated by the desire for this fruit of karma. Tena karanena, because of that reason, aturaha, they are dukkhartaha santaha, dukkhartaha, dukkhena artaha. That is, they are all continuously tormented by some dukkha, some klesha, some sort of worry. They are always worried. Dukkhartaha santaha means they are always in grief, always worried, always sorrowful. Because they always desire something. They think that they want to have something more and then something more. So dukkhartha santaha. Then kshina lokaha, kshina karma phalaha. That is, they may achieve a loka. And then they do stay in the loka for some time. And then as the karma phala declines, kshina karma phalaha. It doesn't totally disappear. Karma phalam totally doesn't disappear. As and when it starts declining, then they come back. They come back. And then Svargalokat Chyavante, they just fall down, they slip down from that. Then the next mantra also is like that, because all these things they are telling about different levels of avidya. Mere Agnihotra ritual initially they said. Then again he said, told about various other types of avidyas, various other types of knowledge. And then now he is talking about Ishtapurtam. This is another type of avidya he is going to say. Various levels of ignorance. Various types of ignorance, let us say. Then let us read. Ishtapurtam manyamana varishtam.
Ishtapurtam manyamana varishtam.
Nanyat shreyo vedayante pramudhaha. नाकस्य पृष्ठे ते सुकृतेनु भूत्वा इमं लोकं हीनतरं वा विशन्ति. Now we are talking about the people who do various good deeds. Number, of course, Ishtapurtam. This word Ishtapurtam is a word which we find in all these dharma shastras, they talk about Ishtapurta. Ishta means yajna. Ishti means yaga. Ishti means some yaga. Ishtam, that is yagam only. Ishtapurtam is various good activities for people. Suppose in olden days they used to dig wells, and then they used to lay roads. They used to plant trees along the roadside, and then they used to dig tanks. So all these good things by rich people, all the wealthy people, they used to do all the good things. Sorry?
Anna Satra.
You build some places of rest for, say, pilgrims. So suppose there is a pilgrimage. En route you build some places of rest and provide food for them. So various types of good activities. So they are called Purtam. So Ishta Purtam Manyamanaha Varishtam. Varishtam means that is the greatest. Of course, Ishta Purtam is also to be done. We should not totally dismiss Ishta Purta. But then Ishtapurta is not the only greatest thing. After that, Ishtapurta gives him good loka, good punyam, etc., etc. But then beyond that, there is jnana. So Ishtapurta we are not totally dismissing. All these things we are not totally dismissing. Because in the very beginning they said, in the very beginning of this adhyaya, we saw tadetat satyam, all these things, they are all which are, they give result, good result. So that from that point of view, all that is satyam. So it is a lower level of satyam, not the higher level of satyam. So Ishtapurtam manyamanaha varishtam, na anyat shreyaha vedayante pramudhaha. Again the word pramudhaha. Mudhaha is deluded. Pramudhaha means very deeply deluded. Prakarshena mudhaha, that is very highly deluded. What do they do? Na anyat shreyaha vedayante. This Shreyas, they do not know. There are two words in Vedanta. One is Shreyas and Prayas. These two words we see in Gita Bhashya. Kathopanishad Bhashya. Gita also we come across Gita Bhashya. But Kathopanishad, we see these words Shreyascha, Prayascha. Shreya is something which is going to enlighten a man, enlighten a person, which is going to lead you on the path of knowledge. Praya is something which is going to give all worldly desires. This is for example, the path of karma. The path of karma is what is called prayas. From that word only we get the word prayasi. Praya, priya means something which is dear. Prayas, something which is dear. There is something which is some fruit of that karma. Because by virtue of karma, you get some wealth, you get some other thing, you are promised of some heavenly loka. So all these things, this is something which is desirable, isn't it? Who wants knowledge? Who wants to know that you are the Brahman? So there may be people like that. There may be people who will say, who wants to know that what is the use of knowing about Brahma? So it is like that. So these people, na anyat shreyaha vedayante. Shreyaha, in contrast to what is prayas, shreyas is something which tells you what is the ultimate good. The ultimate good means that is anaikantika sukham, that is unparalleled sukham, that is what it is. Knowledge is the only thing which sukham, which gives an unparalleled sukham, not many other things. So for example, a person achieves a particular loka, and then from that loka he has to come back, again he has to strive hard and then get some other fruit. But this knowledge is something which is going to give the unparalleled happiness. So that is what it is. That is what is Shreyas. So this Shreyas is not known by this Pramudhaha. All these deeply deluded people, they do not know. Na Vedayante, they do not know. Then, Nakasya Prushte Te Sukrute Anubhutva. Nakam. Nakam is heaven. Swaravyayam Swargana Kastridi Vastridashalaya Amarakosha, if you have seen. Swaha Avyayam, Swaravyayam Swarga Nakaha. So these are the words for various synonyms for heaven. So for heaven, for this Nakam, Anandagiri writes a small explanation also. Kam sukham na bhavati iti akam. Anandagiri, of course, you don't have. Kam sukham na bhavati iti akam. The word ka, the letter ka means sukham, happiness. Where there is no happiness, it is akam, dukkham. The opposite of sukham is dukkham, isn't it? That is unhappiness. Kam sukham na bhavati iti akam. So tat na vidyate iti na akam. Na akam. You see this. Kam means sukham. Akam means unhappiness. Na akam means absence of unhappiness. That is it. Two negatives. Na akam. Na akam. That is na akam. So absence of unhappiness. Akam is unhappiness. Kam is happiness. Akam is unhappiness. Na akam means not unhappiness. Non-unhappiness or absence of happiness. That is unhappiness, sorry. That is what means heaven. So in that heaven there is absence, total absence of unhappiness. So that is the point. Nakasya prushte. Prushte means in that highest place of heaven. In the high place of heaven, prushta. Prushtabhagam, you know. Prushtabhagam means on the back. On the back of heaven. Let us say, you can literally say on the, such a figurative word. Because Upanishads, they are slightly poetic. They are poetic in nature. Kathopanishad also we have seen. Kathopanishad is highly poetic. So these Upanishadic rishis, they are to some extent poets also. When they compose all these mantras, there is some poetic tinge in all these mantras. So Nakasya Prushte means, and on the back of that heaven, they Sukrute Anubhutva, Sukrute Prushte, at the Sukrute, at that highest, Sukruta means something which is Punya, at such nice place, Anubhutva, Sukrute Anubhutva, Anubhutva means having experienced that enjoyment, having experienced that happiness, then Imam Lokam Punaha Vishanti. Imam Lokam means this particular world. This world means having been in heaven for some time. Then again, this world, Imam Lokam, Heenataram Va, or something which is lower. Heenataram means lower. Heenataram Va. Va means or something lower. They either come to this world or they may go even slip down to something lower. So that is what it is. Let us see the Bhashyam. Ishtapurtam. Ishtam Yagadi Shrauta Karma. Shrautam Karma.
Ishtam Yagadi Shrautam Karma.
Purtam Vapi Kupa Tadagadi Smartam.
Purtam Vapi Kupa Tadagadi Smartam Karma.
Okay, Smartam Karma. Okay, Ishtapurtam, he is explaining the word. Ishtam means Yagadi. All these Yagas, most of the Yagas, they are mentioned in the Shruti. Apart from the modern day yajnas like what is this Chandi Yagam and things like that, various other homas, they are all mentioned in the Shrutis. Chandi Yagam, of course, Devi Saptashati. Devi Saptashati is a Purana, from a Purana. So that is a Smartha, Smartham Karma, Smruti. So Yagadi Shrautam Karma, that is those which are mentioned in the Shrutis, are called Shrauta. Then Purta means Vapi Kupa Tadagadi. Vapi is one type of well. Kupam is another type of well. The distinction between them is, one is, in olden days, there used to be two types of wells. One, it's a wide well where you could go down. You could walk down. There used to be steps all around, and then you could walk down the steps and go to that place. That is one type of thing. Vapi is a long barrel-like thing in which you have to draw water. You put a pulley there and then that you have to draw water. Vapi and Kupa. I am not exactly sure which is Vapi and which is Kupa. But then one is that and another type is this. Both are wells only. There is, of course, if I refer to dictionary, you will be able to say, it will be there in the dictionary. So Vapi is one type of well. Kupa is another type of well. Most probably... we don't have a ready, easy dictionary here. It is a very huge dictionary. Okay. Then, Vapi Kupa Tadakadi. Tadaka means a tank, a bigger one, a wide tank. You know the huge tanks we used to have, even now we have. So, these tanks, then Tadakadi, then this is what is called Smartam Karma. Doing all this is all mentioned in various smrutis, dharma smrutis. Then they, manyamanaha, etadeva atishayena purushartha sadhanam, varishtham pradhanam iti chintayantaha, anyad atmajnanartham shreyas sadhanam, ज्ञानाख्यम श्रेयस साधनम् न वेदयन्ते न जानन्ति प्रमूढाः पुत्र पशु बन्ध्वादिषु ओके बन्ध्वादिषु मै बुक सेज बान्धव सीम्स टू बी बेटर बन्धु आदिषु बन्ध्वादिषु बान्धवादिषु इट डजंट मैटर प्रमत्ततया मूढाः ओके विल स्टॉप हियर. So they say, they think, manyamanaha means they think, what? Etadeva atishayena purushartha sadhanam. Etadeva means this only. Etadeva, this only. Atishayena means excellently. Atishaya, excellently, unparalleled way. Then purushartha sadhanam. Atishayena does not mean unparalleled. Atishayena means excellently. Niratishayam, if I say, then it is unparalleled. Then Purusharta Sadhanam, that is the means for achieving the Purusharta, means for achieving all human goals. Then Varishtham means Pradhanam, this is something which is most important. Iti Chintayantaha, they think like that, they fancy like that. अन्यत् आत्मज्ञानाख्यम श्रेयस्साधनम न वेदयन्ते न जानन्ति. सो द अदर वन अन्यत् न जानन्ति, दट ईज आत्मज्ञानाख्यम. सो दट विच ईज कॉल्ड आत्मज्ञान, आत्मज्ञानाख्यम, आख्य मीन्स नेम्ड कॉल्ड आत्मज्ञानाख्यम, दट ईज वाट ईज द श्रेयस साधनम, दट ईज द मीन्स फॉर श्रेयस, दट ईज द मीन्स फॉर मोक्ष, दट ईज द मीन्स फॉर लिबरेशन, लिबरेशन आर एनलाइटनमेंट आर moksha, as we call it, or that depends on the knowledge of self only. Without that is the shreyas sadhana. The knowledge of self is the sadhanam or the means for knowing the highest. Na vedayante, na jananti, they do not know. And who are they? Pramudhaha, prakarshena mudhaha. They are deeply ignorant. How? Pashu, putra, bandhavadishu. Your book says bandhavadishu. Okay, pashu, pashu means animal, putra, sons, children. Bandhavadishu, among with respect to all the relatives, etc. Pramattataya mudhaha. Pramattata. They are all so reveled in that. Matta. Matta is what? Drunken. Pramatta means heavily drunken. They are heavily drunken in that, say, attachment. They are heavily so drunken in that attachment. Pramattataya. Pashu, pashu, pashu dhanam also in olden days, pashu, pashu sampada was the main sampada. Pashu putra bandhava, putra pashu bandhavadishu, pramattataya mudha. So deeply, in such a drunken, infatuation, let us say, with such infatuation. Techa, nakasya svargasya purushte uparisthane. सुकृते भोगायतने अनुभूय कर्मफलम्. ओके, अनुभूत्वा कर्म, दट वर्ड अनुभूत्वा इज देयर इन द टेक्स्ट. ओके, दिस एडिशन इज मिसिंग. अनुभूत्वा अनुभूय कर्मफलम् पुनः इमं लोकम् मानुषम् अस्मात् हीनतरं वा तिर्यङ् नरकादि लक्षणम् यथा कर्मशेषं विशन्ति. ओके, सो दीस् पीपल् प्रमूढाः ते च, एण्ड् वाट् हेपन्स् टु देम्? नाकस्य पृष्ठे, स्वर्गस्य उपरि स्थाने. पृष्ठ ऐ टोल्ड् यु द बेक्, बेक् मीन्स् द हैयेस्ट् प्लेस्, लेट् अस् से अट् द पीक्, अट् द पी आन् दट् पीक्. नाकस्य पृष्ठे, सो अट् द पीक् अट् द बेक् आफ् दट् स्वर्ग, आन् द बेक् आफ् द स्वर्ग मीन्स् रैडिङ्ग् आन् स्वर्ग. नाकस्य पृष्ठे, वेन् यु आर् आन् द बेक् आफ् द स्वर्ग मीन्स् यु आर् रैडिङ्ग् आन् स्वर्ग, यु आर् रैडिङ्ग् आन् दट् स्वर्ग. नाकस्य पृष्ठे, Nakasya Prushte, that is there in Durga Sukta. So in that, on that back of that Nakam, you are there riding on the heaven. Prushte, Uparisthane. Uparisthanam is the highest place. Then Sukrute, that is Bhogayatane. That is the place for Bhoga. Ayatanam. Ayatanam is, that is the place. Bhogayatanam is, that is the place for all enjoyment. Ayatanavan bhavati viri is listen. Ye mantra pushpam. Ayatanam, that is the Bhogayatanam. In fact, Shariram is also called the Bhogayatanam. In Tarkashastra, Shariram is defined as Bhogayatanam Shariram. This is the place where you have to experience your karma phala. Bhogayatanam means not that you have to go and you have to immediately rush to the pub and then you have to drink and then do all revelry. Bhogayatanam means this is the place where you reap the karma phala. Because there is no other way to reap karma phala, isn't it? To have this karma phala. You see, when as a result of karma phala, you go to Devaloka. As a result of karma phala, you go to a lower loka. But where is the place where you have to do some karma and then you have to rectify yourself and then you have to go to a higher place, or all that thing is here only. So that is why this shariram is called Bhogayatanam. So they define shariram as Bhogayatanam shariram. That is in Tarkasangraha. Some such Tarkashastra books, you find that line. Sukrute Bhogayatane. But this is the Bhogayatana, not the Sharira. We are seeing that word in a different sense. So that Sukrute Bhogayatane, in that highest place where all heavenly enjoyments are all there, Anubhutva Anubhuya, having experienced all that, what? Karma Phalam. So he has desired, he has performed some yajna as a result of, as a quid pro quo, let us say, as a quid pro quo, he has gone to that place, he has danced for some time with those damsels, and then he has to come down. Then punaha imam lokam, punaha again, imam lokam means this particular world, manusham, manusham means related to human beings, manusham, related to human, manushya, manusha, something related to humans, asma, asmat, asmat heenataram va. Or something which is lower than ours. Asmat hinataram. Lower than ours. Lower than ours. What is that? Tiryang narakadi lakshanam. Tiryak. Tiryak. Tiryak jantu means a human being walks erect. Tiryak jantu means something which walks with his spine parallel to the ground. We walk with our spine perpendicular to the ground. That is a human being. That tiryak jantu is something which is whose spine is a tiryak. Tiryak means across. Tiryak actually means across. So the spine of the animals, I mean parallel to the ground, so that they are called tiryak jantus. So tiryak jantu.
What is this naraka?
Naraka.
Tiryak naraka.
Yeah, tiryak naraka adi lakshanam. Narakam also is, you know, narakam, the hell. Naraka is hell. Naraka, naraka, you know, the narakam. Swarga, naraka. Contrast to swarga is naraka only. Tiryang narakadi lakshanam means whether it may be tiryak or it may be straight away to hell. So that is it. It may be tiryak jantu or it may be straight away to hell. So that is it. Tiryang narakadi lakshanam, that is characterized by such things. Yatha karma shesham. Depending on whatever karma shesham is there, the balance of karma. Karma shesham means the balance of karma. Yatha karma shesham. Vishanti. Vishanti means pravishanti. They go. They enter. Not even go, pravishanti means enter, they enter. Where, yatha karma shesham, tiryang narakadi lakshanam, lokam vishanti, they enter such loka. Then, again, we are going to a slightly higher level of avidya. We are seeing different types of avidya, isn't it? In the next mantra, we are seeing a different level of avidya. Different level means a slightly higher level of avidya. Let us read the mantra. Tapashraddheye hyupavasantyaranye. शांता विद्वांसो भैक्षचर्यां चरन्तः सूर्यद्वारेण ते विरजा प्रयान्ति यत्रामृतस्य सपुरुषो ह्यव्ययात्मा ओके. Then we are talking about a different type of people. Ye janaha. Ye means those who. Tapaha shraddhe upavasanti aranye. Aranye means aranye sthitva. Aranyam. Aranyam again is a beautiful word. Rana. Rana means sound. Aranyam is where there is absolutely no sound. All this rana guna dhvani we say in Telugu. Rana is sound. Aranya means where there is no noise. Noise of human beings. There may be noise of animals. That's a different thing. Aranya is a place away from all this human human bustling activity. Aranya. Aranya, what do they do? Tapaha shraddhe upavasanti. Tapas shraddhe, dvivachanam. Tapaha and shraddha becomes tapas shraddhe. Tapas. Tapas is physical austerities. Shraddha. Shraddha means with great dedication. Te upavasanti. Upavasanti does not mean fasting. They are not doing upavasam. Upavasa does not mean fasting here. Upavasa in one context it may mean, say, what is this, fasting. But here upavasanti means they live by that. They live by that. They live a very, very austere life with a great dedication, sense of dedication. They live like that. They live in that fashion. Upavasanti. They live in that manner. Then shantaha. Shantaha, you know the meaning of shanti. Shanti means from shamadhatu. Shama means antarindriya nigraha. Those who have controlled their minds. Shantaha. Those who have controlled their minds. Then vidvamsaha. Then they are the people who have learned, who are learned. So all this, it shows that they are learned. They are learned means they are in the right path. They have some theoretical knowledge. They have some theoretical knowledge but not experience. Here Anandagiri is saying, Anandagiri is explaining these people. So, okay, Anandagiri is explaining, kevala karminam phalamuktva सगुण ब्रह्म ज्ञान सहित आश्रम कर्मिणाम फलम संसार गोचरमेव दर्शयति. सो ही गिव्स द कॉन्टेक्स्ट, ही गिव्स द ओवरऑल कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ दिस थिंग. व्हाट इज दैट? सगुण ब्रह्म ज्ञान सहित आश्रम कर्मिणाम. सो दीज आर द पीपल हु आर वर्शिपिंग ए सगुण ब्रह्म. दे आर रिलीजियस पीपल. सगुण ब्रह्म मीन्स in the level of, in the realm of religion. Saguna, saguna means, saguna and nirguna, these two words we know. Saguna means any god thing, maybe form, with form or maybe formless, it doesn't matter, but which has attributes. That is, some god who is doing this creation, say sustenance, etc., who is doing this policing of the world, that is punishing the bad and then rewarding the good, etc. Then who is having his own realm called heaven, and there is another place called hell, etc. So this is a well-defined structure. So those who are, that is what is called a saguna level. So all religions on earth, they belong to the saguna level only. Nirguna level, there is no personality called God. There is no God who is speaking to you. There is no God who is coming and punishing. That is a pure consciousness. Pure awareness, that is what is satyam, jnanam, anantam. So that, in that only we visualize all these things. So that is the thing. So these are the people, saguna brahma jnana sahitaha. So when we say vidvamsaha, they are the people who are in this realm of saguna bhakti. They are in that realm of saguna bhakti. They are doing some austerities, they are also having devotion, they are doing all types of devotion to a saguna god. And then bhikshacharyam charantaha, bhikshacharam, bhiksha, you know. Yeah. Bhiksha means begging. Bhikshacharyam means living by begging. These are the people who live by begging. Bhikshacharyam charantaha, that is, they live by begging. Of course, there may be a question in the forest, who will give them food? Maybe in the forest also there used to be some other grihasthas like Mahashalaha. Mahashalaha, we have seen this Yajnavalkya was a Mahashala. So like that, there may be some other people who had some lot many students and then who had huge establishments in that forest. We do not know. Maybe these are the people who are living in that manner. Bhikshacharya, the spirit of this is, Bhikshacharanam means they are following that aparigraha vrata. Aparigraha means they don't collect wealth, they don't collect and keep it for tomorrow, day after tomorrow, and then not only tomorrow, day after tomorrow, but for years and years together, for sons, children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, etc. Our in India, we try to preserve wealth for children, great-grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren. So these are the people not like that. So bhikshacharyam charantaha. Then what happens to these people? Suryadvarena te virajah prayanti. So yesterday I was telling you about this Dakshina Marga and Uttara Marga. It is also called Pitruyana and Devayana. Pitruyana is all the people who are doing mimir, karma, yajna, etc., etc. But then those who do this karma yoga and also do, say, this bhakti yoga. Karma yoga is for the purpose of chitta shuddhi. And then bhakti yoga is for the sake of nishchalatvam. We use the word nishchalatvam and nirmalatvam in Vedanta. Nirmalatvam is washing off all the dirt in the mind, is called nirmalatvam. That is possible by nishkama karma. But still, the mind, he may not be able to concentrate his mind is not so, still. So, to achieve that tranquility, you have to follow this bhakti yoga or upasana. Upasana means, that is sagunopasana. Sagunopasana, following a particular god form. So that is for god, not exactly god form, particular god idea of god. So that is what is saguna brahma. So that leads to nishchalatvam. It is often compared to a lake. That is, water should also be tranquil and it should also be clear, not turbid. So bhikshacharyam charantaha, their path is something which is called the bright path. Their path is called the bright path as against the dark path. Dark path is the Pitruloka. The bright path is this Devayana. So you can refer to the 8th chapter of Gita, as I told in the last class. Suryadvarena te virajaha. Virajaha means their minds are purified. Rajas, you know. Rajas means actually dust. Rajas is actually dust or dirt. Virajaha, vigata rajaha. Vigataha rajaha yebhya. Vigataha rajaha yebhyaha. We can also say like that. Vigata vigatam rajaha yebhyaha. That is, this rajas has gone away from their minds. They are the virajaha. They prayanti. Prayanti means they go. Yatra amrutaha sapurusho hyavyayatma. Where that Saguna Brahma is there. That is, they go to that Hiranyagarbha Loka. We are referring to that Hiranyagarbha here. Avyayatma does not refer to Nirguna Brahma. It refers to Saguna Brahma, otherwise called Hiranyagarbha Brahma. They attain that Hiranyagarbha Brahma. We will see in the next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.